Hey, what's up guys, this is Daddy Cool and you are watching Satisfactory with the subtitle Megafactory Online. Now in previous episode I have just created a couple of things here, like this steel beam production, and also we have some copper ore coming in from that area, and I have created some copper sheets. There is also an iron mine that I have just put online, and it's delivering a lot of iron ore for me, so that's pretty good. Now in this episode I'm planning to extend the production furthermore, of course, and I try to focus on the space elevator missions, like the ones you can see on the right hand corner. A couple of thousand pieces of products has to be done, and to be able to do that I am planning to create a blueprint designer, and there I will design a couple of things because that's how things work in this game. So that's the plan. I see some problems in here, I suppose. Yeah, this machine is not producing just yet because when I placed it I did not have enough resources to make that thing work, but already it's it can be fed it properly. So let's just connect these. And I'm gonna replace this conveyor. Yeah, probably this was the problem. Now I have MK3, which means okay, it's feeding properly. Now I also see some problem in here. It's very slow for some reason. I mean, there are a lot of ores on this conveyor bed and they should not be there. Oh, that's the problem. Now problem is more or less solved in here. So just to be able to create the blueprint designer I need modular frames, and they are not ready yet. So while I'm waiting, there are still some things that I did not produce yet, and let's just put two assemblers here, and I'm gonna show you very shortly what I'm talking about. So one of them here, the other one in here. So I would like to create encased industrial beams because they need steel beam and concrete, and it just happens that I have the steel beams produced there. Bit overlap, but I do not struggle with that at the moment. And the concrete will be delivered here from a different location just a little bit later. We will solve that. And in the other production machine I'm gonna create the stators, and for that I'm needing the steel tubes, which happen to be very close like that. And let's just take the other things out of here, and I'm gonna connect those very shortly with proper deliveries. How should I do this? Let's put this. Where is it? Okay, and another layer here, so that's gonna be okay for that. Okay, it's done. And what about the other one? That's a good question. Lift. Here it's totally overlapping. If I do it like that, let's change this a little bit. just a little bit. So put this one here. And maybe like this, it won't overlap. Yeah. Okay, so this one requires the wire, okay. Oh, and I almost forgot to give some electricity here. Where should I connect this? To there. And this one to there. Oh, and of course the finished products. Where should I store them? That's a good question. Now, I think I will put both of them into one container this time, because they are just not gonna be used for anything else when they are ready. So let's put a splitter, no, merger into here, like that. Conveyor belt, there you go. Conveyor belt there. And connect. That's fine. And let's check what we were doing in here. This one requires, yeah, the lower one, the wire. The higher one is concrete. So let's take the lower one into here. And the higher one into there. Like that. Okay, let's jump. And maybe it was not the best idea, but now I have to solve the conveyor belt. But that's okay. So, one of them come here. That's the cables, the copper cables, and this one is the concrete, right? Yeah, that's okay. And I'm gonna take them this direction. Oh, I'm missing the iron plates, but the good thing is, here we go. A lot of iron plates in hand. So, like this. And you come like this. So this one is the copper wire, still. This one goes into there. And the other one into here. Now, this should be good. Yeah, a little bit spaghetti-like, but the thing I wanted to do is being sold like that. Okay, they are coming just very slowly, but that's okay. So let's just check the machine once more if everything is fine in here. So you go into this one and that's the concrete, okay. Encased industrial beams under production. Okay, the next thing, yeah, I still have some inefficiency here. There is a place for iron ore and coal that could be theoretically turned into steel. I mean, steel ingots, but there is no space at the moment up here. Maybe if I create, yeah, let's do that. I really want to wait if my plan was okay. Deconstruct this. Deconstruct this. Let's just put that steel factory down here. I think that's a splitter, yeah. And which one? This coal delivery line is the one I can do something with. So let's just here. And I'm gonna put the foundry. If I collect some of those, okay. And foundry, you come into here. Let's lead the coal into there. It's not so nice. Maybe like this. Still not okay. Not working. Still not the best. Oh, it's not really good. Let's take this. And come on. Coal in here, and the iron is gonna come from the splitter. Yep, let's put some energy connection. Where's the pole? Like that. Steel ingots, that's good. And the finished product is coming this way. Misclicked. Let's put it back to 7 and this one to 3. What was there? Ah, whatever. So 7 comes here. Oh, it was the MK1 conveyor belt as 3. This one was 4. Okay. Wonderful. Let's take it here. I think I have to climb up to be able to create my things that I'm planning to do here. So let's put in this. You come here. Okay, and I'm gonna put MK2, let's put a merger here, which is going like that, okay, MK2, and this one is MK1 only. Oh, not good, not good, oh, it's okay. One there, and this one like that. Now that should be okay. For some reasons it's just not producing. What's the problem here? Oh, I did not connect to the electricity. Now it's working. Okay, let's check the other things that I have just installed, and after that I'm gonna create a blueprint. Let's check things here. There we go. Yeah, it's working. Good. That one is not working. What's the problem? Steel pipe and wire. You have fire here, steel pipe, There is electricity. What is the problem? No power. Oh, I see now. Yeah, it was a good idea to come back to check things here. Okay, now everything is producing. Let's take these. Let's take these. Collect things from here. Okay, I'm gonna partially finish the next goal here. Let's put those there and those as well. Those what I need. 2000 pieces of copper wire. There you go. Now that's done. Okay, I'm gonna gather a couple of things to be able to create what I would like to. And some of them for testing. Yeah. And do I have... let's take a concrete as well. Okay, so the next thing is placing this building, the blueprint designer, and I'm gonna put it just here.
Once you have built a satisfactory blueprint, interact with the blueprint designer terminal to save it. It will then be available in the blueprints tab of your build menu. Blueprints can always be edited to correct mistakes or optimize. If you find yourself struggling to work within the set size restrictions, remember that this is a you problem, and efficiency can always be improved.
Okay. That was good. So, let's create a blueprint. So one of the blueprints is ready. This blueprint is creating iron plates from iron ore, which is the first step. I mean, half of the steps for creating reinforced iron plates, and that was one of the plans. Let's do another blueprint. Thank you. Okay, so the second blueprint is ready, and this blueprint is producing 30 iron ores in 220 pieces of screws, which are requirement for multiple reasons, and basically it's a roughly efficient producer layout. And the next thing I would like to do is to create iron ores into rods, because rods are also an essential ingredient for producing the things I would like to do. So here we go, the third one. Welcome back. So this one is also ready. We can produce iron rods in a more or less efficient way. And the thing is that the next step is to place these things into production and create something new. But actually there is a small problem at the moment. Let's just check this quantity. Yeah, it's very low. So my energy production is not the best, and there is one more problem I am facing at the moment. As you can see, this line is not really efficient in delivery speed and probably also in quantity. I'm gonna upgrade these conveyors for a faster delivery, just like this one and this one and this one and this one, and I'm gonna upgrade this one as well, And the reason for that, that this one is producing 300 units per minute, and this can consume 120 pieces per minute. So now there is a small efficiency upgrade in this area, but still I am missing power. So I'm gonna put maybe 4 pieces of biomass burners into here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and let's connect them. I wanna connect them into this conveyor, but here we put a splitter. Yeah, things coming from that direction, like maybe put it closer to this one like that. Upgraded conveyor, very good. And now I can come to this area with a smaller capacity one. Gonna put a splitter into there and one into here. I hope that's gonna be good. Maybe, probably still not. And splitter into here like that. Okay, that has to work. Connect there. This one, no, other one, yeah. Okay, you come there. There you go. And let's give them some power nodes. One, two, three, and four. And how can I like that? Yeah, that's okay now. So hopefully these new biomass burner will create enough energy for me. I mean, capacity should have increased, basically. Yeah, 600, that's good. So at this point I can create the new production area, and I wanna set up the modular frames at least. So that's very important, because as you can see I'm missing still modular frames for the actual goal. So let's just do this. So I was thinking about the expansion of the current base, and I think the best way is to extend it with size and not by more levels. So at the moment this is the highest ground around the area, so I'm gonna start it from here and I'm gonna build this to that direction closer to the base. Maybe put two more. Yeah, like that. Come on. One more. There you go. And at that point I'm just gonna build it as far as I can into that direction. Like that. Okay, this has to go. No more function for that lookout tower, and just build a couple of plates in here. Yeah. And as you can see, the concrete quantity is not optimal, so I have to gather concrete very soon. And let's just put a lookout tower somewhere in here. Where are you? Here you go. Let's put it maybe here. And I'm gonna put one more into here to be able to climb up. So let's check this area really fast. Okay, production blueprints. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. Iron rod production is the first one I wanna start with. And yeah, like this. So the size is 3x4. That's good. And I wanna put this into this corner. Just like that.
Building in blueprint mode can further optimize your construction process with snapping and quick dismantling options. Build modes are not just there to make your work easier, they compensate for inevitable human error. Fixit understands humanity like no other, and humanity needs you to be efficient and productive at all times.
Okay, the next thing is iron plate production, but I am missing a couple of things here. I mean, iron rods will be needed for sure, concrete probably, but reinforced iron plates and cables are absolute necessary to go forward. So let's just gather those resources into hand. So cables will be necessary. Iron plates are more or less okay. I'm gonna arrange things like that. Not gonna need the rotors for now. Okay, let's get some copper. Okay. What else? I'm gonna keep the other things, I suppose, for now. Let's rotors now. I'll take the reinforced iron plates, a couple of those. Okay, iron rod is an issue already. Take the modular frames. Okay, and I'm gonna go upstairs to check steel production really fast. If everything is fine, and actually not fine, because this is not good like this. But the good thing is that I have conveyor belt MK3, and with the help of this I can increase deliveries a little bit. And this one is MK2. So from now on this will be more efficient. That's good. Okay. So concrete, I have to take it from here. There is no other way. I mean, all of my concrete products are coming on that delivery place, and it's not that much at the moment. We will have to handle that. And I'm gonna take one stack of those and all of the products from there, because I wanna feed this machine once again. And you're gonna be steel pipes, the copper sheets, yeah, like that. Screws are not needed, and the rest is okay. So there we have an iron rod production, and the requirement for that thing is 60 pieces of iron ore, and I just happen to have an iron ore source with 30 pieces of iron ore output at the moment, which I can upgrade with an upgraded miner into 60 pieces of iron rods. And that's what I'm gonna do. Let's deconstruct things here and upgrade this one into 60 pieces. Now I would like to feed it with ore, basically, so not even the smelter was required there. There we go. I'm gonna clear everything else from here, like that. Okay, and are you already working? Yeah, that's right. And let's just take it that way, like there. And the feeding will be somewhere here, so I wanna make it straight, like that. Okay. I'm gonna deconstruct the things here just really fast. Yeah. And it was feeding an iron plate production at that point. What do we have here? Basically nothing else. And this container, wonderful, just fits well. Okay. So I should be able to climb up there. I'm gonna go around this time, but maybe it's a good idea to create a lookout tower at the corner. Come on. Okay. So, feeding the system. I placed it like this. Okay. You come here. And that's gonna be the input. And I wanna put a temporary storage container into here. Maybe like this. Yeah, and connect output into here. I don't like the overlapping too much. That's not gonna help either. Whatever, just connect it. And I'm gonna hop down, conveyor belt here, and there is the resource connected, and give the system some power. There you go. Now this one should be working and should be online, and iron rod is going into the container, which I will just feed and use for the assembler for modular frames in the background, because I would like that one to function as far as I am building this area up, because when it's ready, more or less according to my plans, then I will deconstruct a couple of things here, which are basically not bad, but I like this compact version much better. Okay, let's change angle. I mean, field of view. Okay. So the next blueprints I wanna create is the iron plate producer, which is gonna be put into here, and I wanna put another one into here, and the screw production which goes into here. It's maybe overlapping a little bit. Okay, now it's fine. And the other one Let's just put it into here. Okay, the next thing is connecting these things together. This is not gonna be good in here, unfortunately. So I'm gonna put a splitter on these conveyor belts, and you receive resource from that direction. You receive resource from that direction. What's the problem in here? We are not aligning. Yeah, there. This one is going from there, and this one there, and we need one more splitter into here. That's not good. This should now work. Let's put the fast conveyor belt connecting these things. Okay, and you only need the little bit lower conveyor belt up here. Okay, now screw. We have screw coming out here. And another one in here. I'm gonna put a merger. Yeah, merger. And that's the direction. Put it here. I'm gonna use the fast conveyor belts, considering the quantities. And this one just directly connect here. And that's the finished product coming into here. Now the iron plates, one of them is coming out here. Can I place a merger here? Oh, it's a little bit overlapping, but I think that's okay. I can live with this small problem. That's not good position. That's the position. So that's the thing. And let's use the reinforced version. And there will be one more in here. I mean, one more output point. Like this. And like that. Now this should be okay. I mean, here is the reinforced iron, the standard iron plate, and the screws going into that direction, and we have a proper feeding for everything. Now there is one more thing I did not do just yet. I have to go upstairs somehow. Not here. Well, it's a full of machines area. I wanna climb there, yeah. And I wanna give them some electricity connection. And normally that's one section, right? That's the other section. Okay, it's connected. Now, this pole can be connected basically anywhere. Let's do it like this. And now here we have a pole for this and another pole for there maybe. Yeah, now I think we are online. Let's get the iron ore resource for things. I'm gonna make it a secure way. Let's bind this into there. So, oh, one more thing before I go. Iron ore will come from there. Conveyor path 3. You go there. Now this basically should be working. I'm really curious about the system. If my planning was correct, I have chosen this iron resource for feeding those machines. The two screw producer units and the two iron plate producer units require 240 pieces of irons altogether. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Let's upgrade this this miner, and I'm gonna use the MK3 conveyor belt. Like this. Okay, and one more segment into here. Normally, yeah, basically that is in a straight line, more or less. Let's go this way. Okay. One more segment comes here. It's overlapping once again, but I really want to test things if I've done things correctly. So you come here, there you go, and conveyor belt connect there. Now this should be already working well. Let's just check if everything is fine up there. And once it's done, I mean once it's going, I will add the next step for this production line. So iron ore is distributed properly, that's good. The lines will fill up really fast, so at that point I know it's the splitter is not even, but once the lines are filled up, the rest of the resources go to the proper place, so the whole system will just work fine. And there you go, we have already some iron plates coming out, that's good. I'm also waiting for the screws. There you go, screws coming out, iron plates coming out, and everything is fine. Well, regarding the iron ore, I'm not really sure at this point where it was leading, but yeah, that line was cancelled. We will check a little bit later. I would like to first create the things here. Oh, I am really happy about this production quantity and production area, so let's plan the next step. So the next question is how many assemblers I do want to place here. Let's just start it and we will see how this fits. Was it in a good place? Yeah. It's gonna be okay for now. So one reinforced iron plate, I mean one set, requires 30 units per minute from iron plates and 60 from screw, and I just happen to produce 120 iron plates and 230 screws, which means I can set into production 4 reinforced iron plates producer, and that's gonna create 20 pieces of reinforced iron plates. Now these machines gonna produce modular frames, and the feeding is 3 units per minute of reinforced iron plates and 12 iron rods. I have the iron rod on there, and it's giving me 60 units of iron rods. That's okay. And 3 reinforced iron plates. I'm gonna set 3 modular frame production, because I would like to use the reinforced iron plates for something else too. So 10 pieces are used up, or maybe 9, and the rest of them will be placed into a storage as a buffer. Okay, let's create the logistics here. I'm gonna use the conveyor MK2. Face this one this direction, a splitter, and I'm gonna connect this one like this. Okay, so the first, it's always the thirst, like that, like that, and like that. And let's put a splitter here. Yeah, that's okay, that's okay, that's okay. And connect those with MK1. Maybe let's upgrade MK2 and MK2, and normally this should feed those inputs. And I'm gonna put the splitter here like that. That's okay. Another one into there. Oops, wrong direction. Yeah, because it's receiving the goods from the back. Okay, and I'm gonna use the MK2 conveyor belts here. Like there, and the MK3 in here. Okay, and I still need something there, and let's put the things online. Now this is already working nice, and we miss only one thing in here, electricity. So let's put a pole into here, another one into here. I'm gonna bind that there and there, so it's online. Okay, that's fine. So 1, 2, there you go. Good and good. 1, 2, let's put these into line again. There you go, there you go. Now I think everything is under electricity, and these are already working. That's really good. Let's check the output. I'm gonna put a merger here. Yeah, and directing this way, that's okay. Let's put it like that. Another one into here, and another one into here. And I'm gonna put a storage container here. That's gonna be the thing that handles the surplus quantity like that. Connect this there, that one into there, and that one into there. And now, if I am correct, we should be producing, yeah, reinforced iron plates on the desired quantity. So, I think that's the end of this episode, guys. We are halfway to produce modular frames, which are gonna be produced here, but I think that's something that I will do in the next episode. I hope you enjoyed this one, and if you feel like, hit the like button. That helps me support my activity creating videos like this. And thank you for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.